am convinced the academicians, if they are supported by the industry people as chair professor, then that is the right kind of ecosystem to address this type of challenges, because the industry people can read the industry mind and academician can be a support R&D system for that. Therefore, we are now desperately trying to create some chair professor in Chandigarh, and some funding agency, they are ready. But the condition which I am imposing, that I will not take academician as chair professor. The chair professor may not have a PhD degree, but he should have that industrial mindset, the industrial R&D mindset, that he will really guide my academicians to go to that particular solution. And very shortly you will see that some chair professor will create. Because that Odisha model is working. This chair professor model is working. So, because this research assistant professor, research assistant professor, they are dedicated people for this type of activities. This we are also trying in Chandigarh. Because now you go for the group discussion, because it was like a informal way of talking with you. Especially when we look forward to an integration type of this situation, I have a thought process now which I am telling my curriculum development department. Look, there is a concept called A to T, laboratory to theory, rather than theory to lab, which we have gone through that stage. First theory class mein karo, fir laboratory mein 3 months practice karo. But now it is a concept called L to T, that the things which can be covered in laboratory, complete there itself, all theory, everything should be over. So that the students get sufficient time to explore those practices in many sources, and MOOCs in that matter is a good platform, I will say. And Professor Sinha's presentation was more towards the hardware product related, where you need a workshop, you need skilled people to handle this workshop, you need the engineers to engineer those things, but soft products are also possible. And the soft products are basically the soft software tools, like one of the directors, CDAC director, is sitting here. We may not need that big workshop, but we can create intelligent systems through these soft products. So the soft product research is more human integration.
And what about the biological products? I mean, when you say that Ludhiana people, they need a lot of, you want an environmentalist group to sort their problems. And we are working on many of the aspects with the biological problems, chemical threat, biological threat. So, are they included in this?
The company which I am referring to, or that chain of companies, are basically manufacturing company and the hardware tools companies. So, obviously, the this biological products company, they are not there in that particular group which I am referring to. But it is a big market.
Just to give you for example, we work in collaboration with paper industry. They use lots of threatening chemicals actually, and we want to provide them solutions which are environmental friendly chemicals or biologicals. Do they come into like in university we are working from mine to market actually, but market is not coming to our minds actually.
I'll tell you, sir, this is exactly the slouch which is coming out of this particular company which I am referring to. My civil engineering student, this professor, he went there. Then they found, because as you know, cobalt and all these things, they lead to this type of problem. So they collected those slots, because this is one of the product, because they spend 6,000 rupees per 1 ton slots removal. And they create a lot of this slots, so it is a huge money going from that small MSME company. So they told, can you just bring a solution where it can be reduced, or this can be reused, or it can be disposed of without any spending on that. So that also will help. So when we started doing that, now Professor Sood is there, maybe in discussion he will discuss. These people use their student, put some binding, this, that, and this slots has now been tested as some tiles. And very reflective, very nice color tiles which can be put on the wall, not on the surface, because it is slippery. But it is really a wall tiles they created. Then they created some models. And when I saw that, I told, look, the heritage building or the heritage like Gateway of India, the Taj Mahal, this, that, can be prepared as a gift item out of this material, and with some LED or some artistic approach, it will be sold like a big thing. Especially people in Chandigarh, they are very fascinated of giving this type of gifts, so this is a big market for me. Then the question comes, is it carcinogenic or not? whether the biological test has been done, whether it is a hazardous or not. So now they are put in that particular test. They are going for that testing. And when we discussed this, the chairman was not knowing that this can be also converted to the safe. When we showed him this safe, he also realized that something can be done out of this. But now, once the testing is passed, this byproduct automatically, if it is really coming up without any health hazard, then a lot of people, this market, who are ready for this type of gift type of thing, at least Nitter will start some business in that direction. I told my professor Sanjay Sharma that look, whether others are going to support or not, but we'll go for a marketing of some gift item of this product. So these biological things, they are not our, how you are going to help him. But if you can just give them that awareness, look, I can be a part of this thing, they are ready, sir. They are ready. Let me tell you, there is a gap. I agree to that. They will not allow you so easily to go there because we got that access because our the chairman is there. But unfortunately, they were also not sharing a lot of secrecy with us. But gradually they realized that we will go for this. And the condition also, he put that the solution which you give to me, you will not sell this solution to other companies because it is a competitive market. So you will not give that solution to other companies. So NGT fear is there. You have to help them too, because if you are working in that type of area, please try to help them to come out of that fear, and they are ready to spend some amount to get a solution in that respect. So if you can just try to correlate yourself or correlate your activities with that market, maybe we can be a support system, because at least we got a key to enter in that market.
What Professor Prince is saying, because all the mechanical food industry also discharging lot of chemical effluents, lot of inorganic effluents. So remediation process and bioremediation, chemical remediation, I think this institute has a lot of skill, number one. Number two, all that is tool, mechanical tool to increase the strength, lot of coatings are also possible.
Yes, that coating.
I think CSIU already developing, you have already. So this time I think you can.
That is what, as I told you, was a small institute in silo addressing such a big issue. We also have a like a backseat type of approach. There is either backseat or very slow approach to the solution. But if you people can come forward, where we don't know what is your expertise, but if we discuss your expertise, like Dr. Suri is telling, then we can make it a big team and we go there. And now we have accessibility to those requirements. And you study that, be a part to us. And once we provide a solution to one company, they are ready to give the chain. Totally. And we can be a real big system for this Ludhiana-based company at least, at this moment.
Yeah, yes. Rather, I mean, this is something like we have a product which is eco-friendly. We are telling them, okay, this can replace your hazardous chemical, and they have tested it in their R&D laboratory also. It's working fine, but still they are not wanting to take it up. That's the problem.
Since you are coordinating, I think it's...
Yes, sir. Then if you want them to replace their material with your material, they will not agree.
No, they don't agree.
But if you come out with some other technology where their reagents used is reduced, or byproducts which you are getting is also getting reduced as a byproduct, they will agree. If you are talking about the material replacement, absolutely, we have that problem.
No, sir, but their product is not eco-friendly. It's chemically hazardous. Ours is eco-friendly. That's what we are saying.
They talk only two terms, enhance my productivity or reduce my manpower. The chairman's statement also was like that, whatever you do, it should enhance my productivity or reduce my manpower. Ye dono ka solution hai, koi bhi ek solution de do, it is in my favor. But don't ask me to change this material, we have gone through so many testing. And most of product accepted by the international community will not change our material, because my people also suggested that now new materials have come, sir, why don't you use this flexibility, the elasticity, all those things are better. It will not. We will not go to that stage. So there is a rigid boundary. You are constant. It is a very constant problem. The boundaries are not that flexible boundary. With that, we have to find out a solution. So how do you do that? That once we go there, maybe next time when these people are visiting, Dr. Sood, I think sir ka saath thoda coordinate kijiye, Sanjay Sharma ka saath sir ko jodenge. Next visit mein sir ko leke jaate hain, because that is also a very typical issue which if you see physically, because you being a man from that specialization, you can address the problem better than what I am talking now. So let's go there, and if we can, one is environmental issue, another is your automation issue. Any person who is ready here to help us in automation and environmental issues, then be part of our team, because we have a key to the industries. So we can take you there. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So I think all of us agree that this event is kind of like a success. The aim was, the TRICS was created for this very thing. We cannot work in silos. So we need to reach out to other institutes also, as well as to the industry. Sir, as you mentioned, like you went to Ludhiana, and there are so many industries looking for answers. Manu Sharma is here. Manu is here. Manu took a team of young scientists from Punjab University. I also joined them. And we had a meeting with the SIKU, it's their industrial organization, right?
Yes.
So it's the same thing. They have the problems which can be solved without involvement of too much of money. Even they do not see that problem. If you tell them nuts and bolts, ki bhi humko sau bana rahe hain din ke andar, they say ki hum 2000 bana dete hain. Unki aankhein khul jati hain. Can you do it? So these people are working on those things. So like you met some high-ups, I mean the chairmen of those. So probably we can share our experiences when we went. Like, so again, what I'm looking at is CRICS is an ideal forum. Only thing is, this meeting ke baad ye band na ho jaye, sir.
सर एक चीज जो लोग मांग रहे हैं अभी डिजिटल मार्केटिंग कि कंपनी एक्सपोर्ट नहीं मिल रहा है सर चंडीगढ़ में विल बी सरप्राइज्ड शायद आप लोग बिलीव नहीं करेंगे हम लोग वी आर सर्चिंग द एक्सपोर्ट्स हु कैन डू द डिजिटल मार्केटिंग फॉर देम उनका प्लेटफॉर्म को मेंटेन करेगा उनको ही इतना हिट्स दिलाएगा चंडीगढ़ अराउंड पंजाब में उस टाइप का एक्सपोर्ट्स नहीं है आप 1 लाख रुपया स्पेंड करके यू विल नॉट गेट ए डिजिटल मार्केटिंग एक्सपोर्ट्स हियर दे आर चार्जिंग टू मच ऑफ मनी व्हिच एमएसएमई इंडस्ट्री कैन नॉट गिव And मुझे हम लोग अभी अपना कंप्यूटर साइंस दिया because academician all of a sudden cannot be a market ready person and he is a person who is asking 1 month में ये देना है मुझे मेरा जो academician 1 साल ले लेंगे तो उसमें मेरा जो इमेज और the institute का इमेज is at stake तो if somebody is ready for helping us in digital marketing please there is a huge
sir UIUT did something on these lines
but it is very costly yes sir aap
you can come up with a model where you can offset in the points mode if you get a certain sale mode it's not amazon does not have one way to up it you should approach that
we have explored that but the type of the terms and conditions which they are putting It is not acceptable to a MSME industry. A small industry cannot spend that much of thing. So somewhere that sustainable solution type of things is possible. We are looking forward to the startup companies that if koi support de sakta hai.
Rightly said. So somebody can look into those things. Some students they can pick up this idea. okay. So with this, we finish our the first part of this event. Now we start the discussions part. It's more on the very informal time. So how should we do it? Like, should we start from here? From one end, we just go to each and every person? Or institute-wise, how do we do it?
There'll be round table only.
Round table, yeah.
Okay, so like, it's close like 1 o'clock. All right.
We have gone through that stage. First theory class में करो फिर laboratory में 3 घंटा practice करो but now it is a concept called L2T that the things which can be covered in laboratory complete there itself all theory everything should be over so that the students get sufficient time to explore those practices in many sources and MOOCs in that matter is a good platform I would say and professor Sinha's presentation was more towards the hardware product related where you need a workshop, you need skilled people to handle this workshop, you need the engineers to engineer those things, but soft products are also possible. And the soft products are basically the software tools like one of the directors, CDAC director is sitting here. We may not need that big workshop, but we can create intelligent systems through these soft products. So the soft product research is more human integration.
And what about the biological products? I mean, when you say that Ludhiana people, they need a lot of, you want an environmentalist group to sort their problems. And we are working on many of the aspects with the biological problems, chemical threat, biological threat. So are they included in this?
The company which I am referring to, or that chain of companies, are basically manufacturing company and the hardware tools companies. So obviously this biological products company, they are not there in that particular group which I am referring to. But it is a big market.
Just to give you for example, we work in collaboration with paper industry. They use lots of threatening chemicals actually, and we want to provide them solutions which are environmental friendly chemicals or biologicals. Do they come in to like in university, one working from mine to market actually, but market is not coming to our minds actually.
I'll tell you, sir. This is exactly the clause which is coming out of this particular company which I am referring to. My civil engineering student, this professor, he went there. Then they found, because as you know, cobalt and all these things, they lead to this type of problem. So they collected those salts, because this is one of the product, because they spend 6,000 rupees per 1 ton salts removal. And they create a lot of this salts, so it is a huge money going from that small MSME company. So they told, can you just bring a solution where it can be reduced, or this can be reused, or it can be disposed of without any spending on that. So that also will help. So when we started doing that, now Professor Sudhi is there, maybe in discussion he will discuss. These people use their student, put some burning, this, that, and this sludge has now been tested as some tiles. And very reflective, very nice color tiles which can be put on the wall, not on the surface, because it is slippery. But it is really a wall tiles they created. Then they created some models. And when I saw that, I told, look, the heritage building or the heritage like Gateway of India, the Taj Mahal, this, that, can be prepared as a gift item out of this material, and with some LED or some artistic approach, it will be sold like a big thing. Especially people in Chandigarh, they are very fascinated of giving this type of gifts, so this is a big market for me. Then the question came, is it carcinogenic or not? Whether the biological test has been done, whether it is a hazardous or not. So now they are put in that particular test. They are going for that testing. And when we discussed this, the chairman was not knowing that this can be also converted to this safe. When we showed him this safe, he also realized that something can be done out of this. But now once the testing is passed, this byproduct automatically, if it is really coming up without any health hazard, then a lot of people, this market, who are ready for this type of gift type of thing, at least NITR will start some business in that direction. I told my professor Sanjay Sharma that, look, others are going to support or not, but we'll go for a marketing of some gift item of this product. So these biological things, they are not our, how you are going to help them. But if you can just give them that awareness, look, I can be a part of this thing, they are ready, sir. They are ready. Let me tell you, there is a gap. I agree to that. They will not allow you so easily to go there, because we got that access because our the chairman is there. But unfortunately, they were also not sharing a lot of secrecy with us. But gradually they realized that we will go for this. And the condition also, he put that the solution which you give to me, you will not sell this solution to other companies, because it is a competitive market. So you will not give that solution to other companies. So NGT fear is there. You have to help them too, because if you are working in that type of area, please try to help them to come out of that fear, and they are ready to spend some amount to get a solution in that respect. So if you can just try to correlate yourself or correlate your activities with that market, maybe we can be a support system, because at least we got a key to enter in that market.
What Professor Prince is saying, because all the mechanical industry also discharging lot of chemical effluents, lot of inorganic effluents. So remediation process and bioremediation, chemical remediation, I think this institute has a lot of skill, number one. Number two, all that is tool, mechanical tool to increase the strength, a lot of coatings are also possible.
Yes, that coating.
I think CSIU already developing, you have already. So this time I think you get
that is what, as I told you, was a small institute in silo addressing such a big issue. We also have a backseat type of approach. There is either backseat or very slow approach to the solution. But if you people can come forward, where we don't know what is your expertise, but if we discuss your expertise, like Dr. Suri is telling, then we can make it a big team and we go there. And now we have accessibility to those requirements. And you study that, be a part to us. And once we provide a solution to one company, they are ready to give the chain totally. And we can be a really big system for this Ludhiana-based company at least. At this moment.
Yeah, rather, I mean, this is something like we have a product which is eco-friendly. We are telling them, okay, this can reduce your hazardous chemical, and they have tested it in their R&D laboratory also. It's working fine, but still they are not wanting to take it up. That's the problem.
But since you are coordinating, I think it's...
Then if you want them to replace their material with your material, they will not agree.
They don't agree.
But if you come out with some other technology where their reagents used is reduced, or byproducts which you are getting is also getting reduced as a byproduct, they will agree. If you are talking about the material replacement, absolutely we have that problem.
No, sir, but their product is not eco-friendly. It's chemically hazardous. Ours is eco-friendly. That's what we are saying.
They talk only two terms, enhance my productivity or reduce my manpower. The chairman's statement was like that, whatever you do, it should enhance my productivity or reduce my manpower. If you have a solution, it is in my favor. But don't ask me to change this material, we have gone through so many testing. And most of product accepted by the international community will not change our material, because my people also suggested that now new materials have come, sir, why don't you use this flexibility, the elasticity, all those things are better. It will no, we will not go to that stage. So there is a rigid boundary, you are constant, it is a very constant problem. The boundary, they are not that flexible boundary. With that we have to find out a solution. So how do you do that? That once we go there, maybe next time when these people are visiting, Dr. Sood, I think Sarga Sath thoda coordinate kijiye, Sanjay Sarma ke sath Sarko jodenge. Next visit mein Sarko leke jaate hai. Because that is also a very typical issue which if you see physically, because you being a man from that specialization, you can address the problem better than what I am talking now. So let's go there, and if we can, one is environmental issue, another is your automation issue. Any person who is ready here to help us in automation and environmental issues, then be part of our team, because we have a key to the industries. So we can take you there. Thank you so much.
Thank you.